It's on it.
Yes.
All right, cool. Like I said, there's always someone distracting. I never play with one of these headsets on before. Last weekend it was someone else in on a concert. There's always something to take your mind off, you know, but I'm really honored to be here. It's really cool to be in front of you guys and talk about, you know, basically what I've been playing guitar and everything like that. I think it says in the program what I mentioned about Little Bill. He's like a local blues artist, a local blues legend pretty much. I got to interview him for my radio station that I have at the university. He started talking about what music is to him. He says, music's like a puzzle because you never really figure it out. You never quite get it right, you never get it together. And I kind of took that a little further and I said, well, it's kind of it's like a jigsaw puzzle, but when you do get it together, there's still all kinds of cracks and stuff. There's still all sorts of different ways that you can, look at it in a different way and see if there's something you can fill in a little bit. And there's a viola instructor who teaches at the university here too, and a cool thing that he was talking about was he started this nonprofit organization that's a chamber music festival. And he said, basically, he was looking for some way to get the feeling when he was a kid in the backyard, picking up rocks and looking underneath and finding, bugs and kind of stuff like that. He said, that's what he did, so he's discovering new things about music. And that's really what the art form does. And that's really what it is I'm just up here playing this little box of wood with strings on it. I've heard someone put it as one time. But I'm just picking the right notes, and there's always a different kind of thing you can do. Whether I'm just playing something like, or something a lot more smooth. There's always something different. There's always just a different way that you can attack or approach what you're doing. That's kind of just creating a different mood and a different type of feeling. That's why I love doing it, because you get this different, full circle as you approach music, you get this whole different, as I said, a different type of thing each time, each and every time. They inspire different feelings, different emotions, different moods. But I think you already know that's why you listen to it, and that's why I think Donald Trump called music the most popular thing in the world. It's because it basically is. But what I was going to say is that on paper, I can show you how that works. If you want to afterwards, during the conversation hour, I can show you how literally you take a chunk of notes, crunch them up, get this really, distorted feeling, and then resolve. Or something as simple as, it's kind of the things you've been hearing for your whole life, really, that you didn't even really know. And if there's one thing you take from what I say today, it's just that music is basically creating tension, and then relieving that tension. In any shape, any way, shape, or form. That's why as human beings we're really so attracted to it. Subconsciously, that's what's going on, building the tension and releasing it. And as I said, I'm more than happy to literally show you on paper how that works. But I mean, that stuff's been going on since thousands and thousands of years. That's why it's so brilliantly simple. That's why Mozart and Lady Gaga are kind of similar. No, I'm serious though. Mozart will take, augmented sixth chord, runs all of it to subdominant, and then take that to time. But Lady Gaga, she just knows exactly when to let the beat drop. It's the same thing. It's the same, I'm not even kidding. Certain levels of complexity and whatnot, but it's just about rubbing that tension and relieving it. It's kind of like a manipulation in a way. The composer always knows that he has this effect on the listener. He knows that he can take his music or her music, and I'll organize it in a way that's going to make someone feel something. And it's not necessarily a malicious thing at all, it's just because I think the reason why I say it's not malicious is everybody involved in the process has the same feeling. The composer wants to instill the same feeling in him or herself as the listener. And the last thing I kind of want to say is, I know that there's some people out there, I know for a fact that they don't want to pick up an instrument or don't want to play guitar. Haven't had a chance to do it yet. I just want to say that, you got to do it. There's really nothing about it. The fact that you've been trained, you don't even realize you've been practicing music since the day you were born. The first thing you ever heard, the first thing is the kind of music you've been listening to, maybe the first time you ever watched the Sound of Music, it's the first time you ever heard my ears. Okay. you've been trained, you have these patterns, you have this tension, you get, you feel, and you have a way to resolve it. So, why not try it out? It's just about learning how to learn and taking things in small chunks and getting the confidence to take it up to the next level. I know I certainly would not be alive if it wasn't for it. I don't really think it'd be worth, you know, the time, but definitely give it a try. That's about all I have to say.